स्टूडेंट्स, हम लोगों ने डिजिटल ट्रांसमिशन की बात की, हम लोगों ने एनालॉग ट्रांसमिशन को डिस्कस किया था, और अब हम डिस्कशन स्टार्ट करेंगे अबाउट अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक इन टर्म्स ऑफ द फिजिकल लेयर कॉन्सेप्ट्स. स्टूडेंट्स, टॉपिक इज बैंडविड्थ यूटिलाइजेशन. हमारे पास मल्टीपल टेक्निक्स हैं बाय विच वी कैन एक्चुअली मेक द बैंडविड्थ यूज मोर एफिशिएंट इन आर लिंक्स और चैनल्स. Students, bandwidth is a precious resource. In data communication system, if we are not utilizing the bandwidth that is available to us via a link between the two devices, we are actually losing out on having an efficient data communication system. Yes, bandwidth ko hume fully utilize karna is very important. Students, aage chalke aap dekhenge ki hamare jo latest transmission medium hai, the one that we use in the modern data communication systems, for example, optical fiber, for example, terrestrial microwave and stuff, both of them, or you know, even modern transmission medium other than that, they've got a very large amount of bandwidths that are available. Normally, our transmission signals that we need to transmit from point A to point B, their bandwidth requirement is very low. So our link has got a higher bandwidth available, and our individual signals that we need to transmit, they have got very low bandwidth requirement. So students, we need to find a way, we need to find a mechanism by which we can have multiple signals, use this bandwidth of the link fully so that no bandwidth is wasted. Students, there are multiple techniques that we are going to be talking about in this discussion. The first one is multiplexing. Students, multiplexing is nothing but the combination or combining individual signals which have got lower bandwidth requirement into a link which has got a higher bandwidth requirement. Students, इस पर्टिकुलर केस में हम लोग मल्टीप्लेक्सिंग के कॉन्सेप्ट को इस तरह से भी समझ सकते हैं कि बिकॉज ऑफ द हायर ट्रैफिक नीड्स the data communication systems are getting modernized day by day, our traffic is increasing. So we have got two options. The first option is every time new traffic or new links need to be transmitted on this higher bandwidth link, what we can do is we can add one extra link, and then that extra link can carry our additional signal. Students, another alternative is that we can install a link with a higher bandwidth, and then whenever new signals need to be transmitted, they can actually go and utilize the bandwidth, the existing bandwidth that is available on this higher bandwidth link. Students, slide ki janib chalenge, and we'll try to understand this first concept of multiplexing a little further. Students, as you can see, in this particular case, we are using two pieces of hardware. The first one is on the sending end, and that is a mux or a multiplexer. And then on the receiving end, we have got a DMUX or a D-multiplexer. Students, in this particular case, our multiplexer is a mini to one device, and our D-multiplexer is a one to many device. स्टूडेंट्स, गौर कीजिएगा कि इस केस में वी हैव गॉट ओनली वन लिंक, वन हाई बैंडविड्थ लिंक, एंड देन वी हैव गॉट मल्टीपल चैनल्स, वी हैव गॉट एन चैनल्स इन दिस पर्टिकुलर केस. स्टूडेंट्स, वी हैव गॉट एन सिग्नल्स विच आर शोन बाय एन इनपुट लाइन्स, एंड व्हाट वी डू इज वी एक्चुअली पास देम थ्रू अ मल्टीप्लेक्सर. Multiplexer combines these input signals in the form of multiple channels. So for n input lines, we will have n channels, and these n channels are nothing but they are the portion of the link, the higher bandwidth link that carries our transmission between the given pair of devices, the given pair of lines. So one link can have multiple channels. Our multiplexer combines multiple input lines into these n channels to be sent over one link, and our demultiplexer, which is a one-to-many device, again takes this stream and then converts this into n number of output lines, and we get our original signal back.